Student Vitaliy Kuzmenko пришел на Майдан Незалежності.
Vitaliy Kuzmenko was one of the students who came to Kyiv's Independence Square right before the group was attacked. He joined others who were protesting for days in support of the association agreement with the EU. They were peaceful protests, with songs, placards and tea. On November 30th, in the middle of the night, on these stairs, a new page in Euromaidan history began.
We were pushed back and gathered in one place. We had no chance to escape. They started beating us, pulling people out, one by one, out of the crowd. I tried to hide. I was pulled down from the stairs, dragged onto the other side of the street. Then I spent several hours in a police van. That night, there were around 200 people on Kyiv's Independence Square. Most of them were university students. Vitaliy was among those beaten up by the security services. I was severely beaten. I ended up with a concussion and a broken arm. More than 80 people were injured. About 36 were detained. It was the first attempt to disperse Euromaidan. It led to a new stage of the protests. In a day, millions of people took to the streets across the country. We had no choice but to go forward. Vitaliy returned to Euromaidan as soon as he left the hospital. His arm was in a cast. I couldn't fight, but I could do everything else. My elbow joint was broken, and I had to go through some rehabilitation. However, the events that were happening in February took my mind off my broken arm completely. It was one long day, from the 18th of February through to the 20th. It all merged into one day, starting from the morning of the 18th. On the 20th of February, I couldn't understand what was happening. Dead bodies were lying on the streets. We were going up the Institutskaya street and saw those bodies. According to official data, 107 people were killed during the anti-government protests. Most of them were shot in central Kyiv, starting on February the 18th through the 20th. 2 days later, Yanukovych and his associates fled the country. There was no euphoria after it all happened. For me, Maidan ended when Yanukovych was ousted. From that moment, our country needed changes. Vitaliy planned to graduate from university and develop his business, which he opened shortly before Euromaidan. But Russia's annexation of Ukraine's Crimean Peninsula and its military intervention in eastern Ukraine made him rethink his goals in life. When your country is at war, you can't just sit in Kyiv and think that you have done enough and proceed doing other things. Vitaliy served as an intelligence officer. In 2016, he returned to civilian life. Now he's working with others who fought in the war to create the Ministry of Veterans. Reporting by Yevhenia Bodar, UATV.